Finally, tonight, as a day of pageantry and festivals draws to a close, we have for you a tale from two cities, a tale of two weddings, from producer Don Mosely and Carol Marin.
Here is the stuff of which fairy tales are made.
The royal couple, the Chicago couple. Some similarities here. As Charles is older than Diana, Donald Stell is older than Mitzi Friedland. As the prince and his lady chose this day as theirs, so did Don and Mitzi. And as all the world watched the ceremony in London, there was enough media attention at the county building in Chicago to assure that at least this area would learn about this wedding. Don Stell and Mitzi Friedland got to the county building early at 8:30 this morning. They were the first to arrive. While for her wedding, Diana Spencer wore ruffles and diamonds, Mitzi Friedland chose jeans and a sweater. As Prince Charles was attired in full uniform, so is Don Stell, his Texaco uniform.
What are you going to do now that...
I got to go back to work and tune up a couple of tires.
We're working people, okay? Working people are not royalty, okay? And we live a quiet life, and I felt we should be married quietly, or I thought, for a while.
One could make the argument that marriage here in the county building in Chicago is considerably less glamorous, considerably less impressive than marriage in a cathedral in London. But to the people who work here at marriage court, that argument does not carry much weight.
Good morning, marriage card.
To Joan Healy, clerk of the marriage court and a veteran wedding watcher for 25 years, what goes on here is no commonplace. It is an occasion.
All the weddings here are royal weddings. Why would I get up at 3 o'clock in the morning to watch a wedding?
Judge Marilyn Rozmarek Komosa, who divides her time between eviction court and marriage court, echoed the same sentiment.
Every ceremony is very important. I think the Archbishop of Canterbury today made a remark that every couple getting married is really a king and queen in their own household.
There is an ancient Christian tradition that every bride and groom on their wedding day are regarded as a royal couple.
Do you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
I do. I will.
And so this morning, two couples in two cities exchanged their vows and became husband and wife. The royal procession led to breakfast at Buckingham Palace. The Chicago wedding contingent made its way upstairs to the fourth floor offices of Cook County Clerk Stanley Kusper, who in conjunction with cheesecake aficionado Eli Schulman presented a cheesecake wedding cake to the first couple to be married in Chicago today. Historic events need chronicling. In England, world media were on duty. In Chicago, everyone from local TV to Newsweek were in attendance. And when, finally, it was over, the newlyweds here and the newlyweds there departed. The royal pair chose a horse-drawn carriage and waved as they passed the thousands who lined the parade route. The Chicago pair, cheesecake in hand, walked down their parade route, which ended at the Easy Park lot on Clark near Wacker. Before going, a few parting words.
Was it as nice as the royal wedding?
You people made it as nice as the royal wedding, yes. You did. Thank you.
Thank
You're
you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
I couldn't be more happier than I am right now.
A Buick, a coach, a royal couple, a working couple. In each case, cause for celebration. Carol Marin, NewsCenter 5.
I want to acknowledge one Charles Sanders, one of our fine videotape editors who put that piece together.
And also say to Don and Mitzi Stell, they really accepted all of this media attention that came to them as such a surprise on their big day with wonderful grace. Our congratulations to both of them.
It's a nice story. Makes for a nice ending to a show. Incidentally, the royal wedding, what they have, 13 cakes.
One was five feet tall.
Right.
But I'm glad the Stells got to take their cheesecake home.
I prefer cheesecake anytime.
That's true.
That's the news tonight. We hope you have a good evening, and we'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, everybody. Good night.
MGM presents one of the most beautiful women of our time in the most erotic adventure of all time. Tarzan, the Ape Man. Playboy magazine calls Bo Derek the sexiest Jane ever. Bo Derek, Richard Harris, and Miles O'Keefe in Tarzan, the Ape Man, rated R.
Now playing at a theater near you, check newspaper for feature times.
To feel like an insider at this week's royal wedding, you have to read this week's People and meet some of the people who made it all work. People like the grandmother who made Lady Di's wedding garter, the English silk farmer whose cloth became the wedding gown.
People like the coachman getting them to the church on time.
The people who made their bed, king size, of course.
People like the cake maker who's in the Navy.
And other everyday people who talked about the royal couple.
Plus a revealing story about what Joan Baez is up to these days.
And very serious criticism of the Beverly Hills diet. So treat yourself.
Treat your family.
To this week's people. Where you're invited behind the scenes at the wedding of the year.
When you slice into Jewel's Farm Stand watermelon, you're in for a treat. Because our watermelon is so juicy, so sweet, that the only thing nicer is the price. Through next Wednesday, whole watermelon is only 8 cents a pound. Then fire up the grill for a main course favorite, Jewel's Grade A Whole Fryers. Through next Wednesday, they're only 47 cents a pound. Save on main course meats and summer sweets at Jewel.
Tomorrow on NewsCenter 5 at noon, Walker Merriman, spokesman for the Tobacco Institute, joins Channel 5's Peter Nolan. The Tonight Show is next. Geneva Summer Theater Festival presents outdoor performances, Shakespeare's Taming of the Shrew, Thursdays through Sundays through August 2nd.